sure. We got to prep for the rain, the wind, and especially, like you were saying, along the coastline, there's going to be that high wave, rip current, certainly. So just be on the preparation side over the next few hours. And really tomorrow, you'll have lots of time to prepare. It's really as we move throughout tomorrow, where conditions are going to kind of decrease and get more gloomy and rainy. Here's a live look into Ocean City. You can see the waves are already quite choppy. This guy's taking in, taking advantage and getting some surf fishing in there. But you certainly want to stay out the water, as we do have rip currents risk high across the Delmarva Peninsula there and farther north. That wave height is only going to increase into the weekend. And then here closer to home, we are going to see coastal flood advisories go back in effect into the evening hours and into our midnight hours. That wind, as that nor'easter makes its way farther north, is going to just push that water into our area. So the City Dock, Naval Academy, those low-lying flood-prone areas, certainly want to be prepared for some minor coastal flooding during those high tides. Looking at our temperatures right now, starting off our week, our afternoon, with temperatures in the 60s. We're at 62 at BWI Marshall, 60 downtown. We're looking at 60 in Woodstock, 59 in Frederick, warming up only to the mid 60s once again for this afternoon. We're still going to see lots of sunshine, so that is going to be pleasant, but temperatures are certainly going to be cooler than where they should be for this time of year. We're going to have another cool evening, but not as chilly as last night. Gonna have some cloud cover that will kind of act like a little blanket, but it's still going to get quite cool. Looking at temperatures into the 40s, so we're not going to see the 30s overnight like we did again last night. Now the rain chances will increase into the weekend. We're looking at around a 40% chance for Saturday. The rain will really pick up overnight and into Sunday, and that's where we're going to see the bulk of the rain. Here's a look at that nor'easter as it makes its way farther north. That area of low pressure mainly sticking out shore, but as we move closer into the weekend, we'll see if that nor'easter tries to make its way inland or it curves out to sea a little bit. But either way, certainly the eastern shore and us here in the Baltimore metro, we're going to get in on some rainfall, much needed. It has been dry, but when you track out the rain from Saturday to Monday, some areas could see close to 3 inches of rainfall. And of course, on the eastern shore, closer to that low, that's where those rain totals will be much higher. So we got impacts on icons on for both Sunday and Monday. We're keeping a close eye on Sunday's forecast because we've got a game day here in Baltimore. The Ravens will be playing at M&T Bank Stadium. I can tell you right now that forecast looks a little wet and windy. 65 is going to be the afternoon high, so it's going to be chilly as well. We'll continue with those conditions into our Monday drive.